Everybody, it's your boy MC from MCTV. Glad to be back. Let's talk about Devin Haney and George Kambosos Jr. You know, Devin Haney went through loops and hurdles just to get this fight made with George Kambosos. When George Kambosos beat Teofimo Lopez, he promised that he was going to fight Haney next and he wasn't going to put on none of that BS. He said that he realizes he wasn't undisputed, and he even claimed that Teofimo Lopez was not undisputed. Rightfully so, because in his possession was a franchise belt, okay? And with the franchise belt, it does not replace the original belt, the WBC belt. So therefore, he is not undisputed. And when you look at, you know what I'm saying, the records of who was undisputed in the history of boxing, there's only six individuals. Terrence Crawford looks like he's about to be next up if he fights Josh Taylor, even though he was undisputed, I believe, in a different weight class. All right, any one of those guys could be undisputed. Canelo Alvarez, I believe, was the first. Canelo Alvarez, he became the sixth person on the undisputed list recently by cherry picking whoever he cherry picked to fight, but he won those fights. Okay, he did what he had to do. Kind of confused about Canelo because of his PED usages. All right. But so Teofimo or George Kambosos was never undisputed. That's my point. Okay. The next part of my point is this. The fight that's about to happen that he went through loops and hurdles just to make happen is going to be for undisputed. Okay. So we're going to get an undisputed champion at 135 super lightweight division since Sweet Pea Whitaker. Okay, he was the last person in that weight division to become undisputed champion of the world. Okay, I'm betting on Devin Haney. I believe in Devin Haney, you know what I'm saying? Y'all know what it is, you know what I'm saying? Kambozo, or whatever you want to call him, the doofus, you know what I'm saying? He's a capper, he's a liar, he didn't stick to his word. He tried to put a time limit on Haney, giving him different treatment, giving preferential treatment and favoritism to Lomachenko. Doesn't make no sense. Dude doesn't hold no belt. Is in the midst of a war. Okay. Even reject the fight a few different times. All right. So, Kambosos, man, I used to like him like everybody else did right after that Teofimo Lopez fight. I was happy somebody beat Teofimo because of what he was doing in the game and the mimic that he was portraying. Okay. But now we see that we get Teofimo 2.0 and Jorge or George Kambosos of Australia. Okay. Deep down under. Okay, wherever you want to call it, all right, bro? But guess what? June 4th, we're going to get that fight that Devin Haney deserves. He's been blackballed. He's been neglected. He's been ostracized. He's been ignored. His own team and his own promoter, Eddie Hearn, has done him dirty. They haven't given him the respect that he deserves. Fighters have been avoiding him, doing everything that they can to keep him on the outskirts, okay? People have been pulling out of fights. People have been trying to take over his current fights just to mess his opportunities up. But the fact of the matter is, Devin Haney seems to be and is the absolute boogeyman at 135. Okay, so get that through y'all's head, all right? Now we finally got this fight. That's what's up. I can't wait to see Devin Haney's name added to the list. But first, he got to do that work. And I ain't going to lie to y'all. You know, Kambosos, he is very, very fast. He's extremely fast. In fact, he is lightning fast. Okay, and he's got some precision. Okay, and he doesn't seem to be just some hunky-dory old dude. But I know Devin Haney has what it takes to give what he's got equally plus more, like I said about Wilder. But the difference is, you know, this dude might even be granted the opportunity to cheat in the ring by the higher's up, by the higher-ups, okay? And if that happens, I still think Devin Haney has what it takes to lay him out and beat him, because Devin Haney is just that psychologically thoughtful and talented physically, okay? He can get it done. He can make it happen. Y'all know what it is. It's your boy MC from MCTV. We're going to be staying tuned on this fight.